What to start out with? What's like romantical? Ah, perfect. Aw, yeah, girl. Yeah. Well, it's good to see people here already. Awesome. Yeah. Rough. That's exactly right. Rough and ready, that's right. That's exactly right. Cool beans. How's the sound? Is my voice and the music all right, or is the music too loud, or am I too loud? Hey, Starry. You can barely hear the music. All right, let me turn it up a little bit because this is good shit. Yeah. Loving you is wrong. I don't want to be right. Am I wrong to fall so deeply? Oh, I think you need this music. Because it's fucking dope. Me too. Am I wrong to hunger for the gentleness of your touch? No. Girl. Needs me just as much. And are you wrong to give your love? It is like stardust. Sprinkle that shit everywhere. And am I wrong for trying to hold on to the best like that. Like if love and you is wrong, I don't know. Wiggly, what are you doing? Are you ready to get all sexy? Me too. All right, I'm gonna excuse myself for just a minute just to let people filter in, whatever. But I will be right back. Hey, Danny. Awesome sauce. So, talk amongst yourself for just about 5 minutes tops, but I will be right back. And then we'll get started. Move, bitch, get out the way. Get out the way, bitch, get out the way.
是我。
All right. Ooh, John B. That's what I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, don't be surprised if I'll, like, be playing and, like, I'll just start grooving because it'll be a good song. So, just FYI. So, I figured we'd get started, of course. And I figured first we'd do Jurassic Heart because it's relatively short. Then, Then we could do kind of a boat. We can either do Hateful Boyfriend or we can do Wario Date. Wario Date, I've seen it played by Vinny of Vine Sauce. Jurassic Fart, yes. Hateful Boyfriend is kind of long. Okay. Well, we'll play the game first, the first one, and then we'll, like, you can give tips good because I have never played Hateful Boyfriend. But we'll do Jurassic Heart first, and then we'll kind of see how things go, and then we'll kind of go from there. Because I do want to play Wario Date. It looks amazing. All right. So here we go. Get my shit here together. I know, I was thinking the same thing, Danny. I thought, you know, if I played Wario Date, MT has to be here, but that's okay. I will definitely upload the stream to YouTube after this, and then whoever, you know, couldn't make it out with us today, they can watch it later. But, she is missed, definitely. Let me turn it down a little bit. Oh, and if you want to request some songs, you know, let me know and I will play the song that you request because this is, I am DJMD today. We'll play some sexy shit. DJ Mad Diggy. Aw, yeah, girl. He sweat. Aw, yeah. Alright, so let's go ahead and get started here. Let me move this a little bit so I can see things. I need a bigger monitor for this kind of shit. Alright, here we go. Hopefully the sound isn't too bad on this. I think it has sound. I wonder if I could turn the sound off if I wanted to. Please enter your name. I can do that. I think. Mad Dog. The best name. The sexiest name. Oh shit, it's got sound. Fuck. Really, you can't turn off the damn sound? That fucking sucks. Might as well turn this off. Sweet Dinosaur Love, yes. Alright.
Let's get this started and go on our fucking date with this fucking dinosaur. Alright, it's time to go buy a ukulele with Ty Raccoon. Sugoi. Maybe I should buy him a meal too. I'm the reason why his old one is broken after all. What the hell, did I smash it on stage? Maybe I didn't. Come to think of it, isn't this going to be the first time I meet him outside of school? Oh shit. Hoi! I did break it in one of my rabid rages. The first thing I do when I rage is I break every fucking instrument. Makes my heart go doki doki. Now that makes me nervous. Better make sure I don't look funny. Let's see, which hair clip should I go for? Okay, you guys help me choose. Which one should I pick? The usual fossil-shaped hair clip, treble clef-shaped hair clip, meat-on-the-bone-shaped hair clip, not wearing any. The wiener-shaped one. You know I would. Meat-on-the-bone? The dankest one? Meat-on-the-bone, I mean, that's kind of wiener-ish. This one is pretty cute. It looks yummy too when you eat that shit. Hopefully Ty Raccoon will like meat like I do. Aw yeah. I love meat, man. All set. Now I better hurry and go meet him at the station. The light rail station. Oh, there he is. Hello, Ty Raccoon. Did I make you wait? Not at all, Mad Dog. I just got here as well. Look at his little tie. I love that. He likes to beat his meat and you like to watch a mutual interest. I know. By the way, that hair clip, oh, he's gonna say some shit about it. Oh, this? I thought it might be good to wear something different once in a while. And my favorite food is meat, so... Oh, really? I like meat, too. I don't know how I would have not guessed that. Wow, I didn't know that. Maybe we could have a grilled chicken for dinner? Aw, yeah. That doesn't sound so bad, actually. Looks like this is going well. Oh, freaking God forbid. Hey, Kvat, how's it going? Good to see you. Glad you can make it out. Looks like this is going well. Well, God forbid I choose the wrong fucking hair clip. Jesus. Oh, this is your first time. I'll be gentle. Aw, yeah, girl. So, ready to get your new ukulele? Yes, let's go. Are we going or what? Or are we just gonna stand here like idiots? Okay, there we go. Alright, let's get you a nice ukulele. Wow, you're really fired up about this, aren't you? Ty Raccoon, I'm the one who put you into that situation with the music club. Of course, I feel bad. So choose whatever you like. It's on me. Yeah, about that. I know how you feel. But I want you to know that it wasn't your fault. You didn't know that I'd panic in front of people. I did. And I dropped my old ukulele, breaking it into pieces as a result. Aww. I also panic in front of people. Which wouldn't happen if I didn't force you to play in front of them. But you didn't. I chose to do it myself. If you were forcing me, I wouldn't be here. Really, I'd feel terrible if you had to pay for something I did. So just let me pay for it, okay? It's hard to tell from his face, but he sounds really upset. What should I do? Alright. Which should I choose? Insist on paying? Hey, Collie, how's it going? Glad you could make it out. He sounds pretty, like, torn up about it. So, you know what? I'm gonna have him pay, because I didn't bring any fucking money anyway. This is a big party. This is the largest turnout I've ever seen, I think. Okay. You're right. I should have thought about how you feel. I'm sorry, Tyra-kun. It's all right. I'm glad you understand. The Mad Weens? Oh, I thought that said shit for a minute. Shit, I feel like I should do something. Is there anything I can do to make it up? Well, how about help me choose a ukulele? You know what? Let's just, like, not choose a ukulele. Let's just get a fucking Fender. And then we'll jam out. And then we can go to a drum circle afterwards. How about that? And I'll treat you to lunch. Okay, okay. You really don't give up, do you? Mad Dog never gets up. Mad Dog is tenacious. Well, I did give up on paying for your ukulele, which I never intended to do. Fair point. Alright, our ukulele won't choose itself, will it? Let's go find one. Okay. Fedora. Yeah, let's buy a fedora instead. How does a T-Rex fit in a store? That is a mystery. No one knows. I know you have fedoras, they're fucking cool. We spend our time looking for a ukulele that we both like. After looking through the store, we finally find a solid wood one. Maybe it's a warehouse. Maybe that's it. It's a dinosaur store. Yep. I think the size is a bit too small for him. Obviously, it's a fucking ukulele. Damn, T-Rex is playing it. I hope we teleport in. That'd be cool. But hey, as long as he's happy with it, right? After that, we go to the park and have some grilled chicken there. Tyra-kun must really love them. He eats them really, really fast. Slow it down, man. Enjoy it. Oh shit, it's getting real right now. It's getting real. Oh, I didn't realize it's evening already. Me neither. Neither did I. I guess it's time to go home, huh? I'll walk you to the station. Thanks, Mad Dog. That's very nice of you. You're welcome. Well, what's wrong? Oh, it's gonna get real right now. There's burble boyfriends with guns. Holy shit. May I ask what you are going to do after this? Oh, well. What am I gonna do? To be honest, I'm not gonna do shit. I'm just gonna go home and cry. Or masturbate, whatever. Cry and masturbate at the same time, probably. God, this coffee's good. Oh shit, it's getting real. If that's a tons of homo. Not much, really. Why? It's getting real right now. Oh, look at him blush. It's adorable. Well, I was wondering if you could stay a bit longer. Aw, yeah, girl. Slip him the tongue. I might not come back with my tongue. I have something to talk to you about. Of course. Really? Thank you. So what do you want to talk about? Sexy shit. Well, it's about my fear of performing in front of many people. Aw, shit. What would the children look like? Probably like my brother. I've never told you this, but I was never like this, up until junior high school, that is. I see. What happened? I don't really care, but tell me anyway. Well, my body was still small, it was easy for me to pick up a ukulele. During junior high school, I started growing bigger, and things weren't the same as they used to be. Oh, we've all been there. During a concert at school event, there was an accident. Someone tripped and hit me, making me drop my ukulele. Aww. I tried to pick it up, but I couldn't. I shouldn't laugh. Not with my tiny arms like this. Ty Raccoon. I was struggling trying to pick it up. I would have laughed. But that only made things worse. The audience started laughing. Aww. Giggles grew into hysterical laughters. Laughters? Would that be... Oh, well, I'm not the grammar police here. It was horrible, to say the least. My friend helped pick my ukulele up, but it was far too late. Fucking sorry. That was like puberty for me. One time, it was not a problem having, you know, not a small, big, large dick yet, but then one day it was, and then I had to get, like, fucking bigger pants. Like Zubas, like the pants with the cool designs on them and shit. You know what I mean? Then I was fucking rocking it. Anyway, I couldn't move a single muscle. I just stood there, frozen. Aww. Did I have to have a dick reduction? No. Hell no. You gotta deal with that shit. That's what being an adult is like, man. This is the real world. Ever since that day, every time I perform in front of many people, I couldn't help but asking myself these questions. Okay. Well, I thought that's... I read that as, will I drop my pants? Yeah, you can't. I don't know why. I don't know how to adjust that. But you see, I have to curse, like, creatively. Will I drop my pants? I know I ask myself that every time I go somewhere. What would happen if I did? Magic. Will they laugh at me? Hell no. Ellipses. I'm so sorry. I should have told you about this before I agreed to perform. No, you were really brave, you know. Knowing that you're scared, but you still tackle the problem head on. I admire you for that. Thank you, Mad Dog. It's really weird because when I perform in front of you, none of those thoughts ever cross my mind. Aww. Somehow you're special. I'm special. Maybe it's because there was no human at your concert. That's why me as an audience didn't remind you of anything from that event. Maybe. But whatever it is, I'm thankful for it. Aw. You all are special to me too. Maybe, but whatever it is, I'm thankful for it. I'm glad that it's you. Aw. No, Tyracoon is making me blush. Whee! My heart's going doki doki. So is my wiener. It is going doki doki. Thank you for sharing this with me, Ty Raccoon. And thank you for listening. And for giving me courage. You know, I just got an idea. If you're worried about picking up your ukulele, I'll do it. Huh? I'll do it. When you perform, I'll be there. And if you drop the ukulele, I'll dive in. Grab it. Grab it and throw it right back at you. Hopefully you catch it. That's crazy. You're crazy, Mad Dog. You're just crazy. What the hell? This guy's crazy. I'm fucking stupid. Well, maybe the throwing part is. No, it's not. The point is, you don't have to worry. You thought he'd say he'd die. Maybe he would. I'll help. You can count on me. Mad Dog. Aw, look at him blush, he's so cute. Holy shit, Colonel Silver. What's up, bro? You came just in time for the romantical part. Thank you, that means a lot to me. Aw, shit. Just be careful and don't step on me when I'm picking up your ukulele, okay? Yeah, don't step on me. Finally, I have realized my dream of bonding with the T-Rex. The next step... You know what the next step is. It's sexy. Of course I won't step on you. You better not, bitch. I know you won't, I was just messing with you. You know what? We haven't actually tried that new ukulele of ours. How about a song before we go home? Aw, yeah. Here in the park? Fuck yeah, in the park. Take your clothes off. Oh, wait, you're already naked. Well, there's nobody around but us. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And even if there is, I'll show you how fast I can pick your ukulele up. And how fast I can pick your dick up. He should play the bad touch. Too much booty in the pants. Play that on the ukulele. Anyway, so are you in? Well, okay. That's the spirit. Fuck yeah, dude. Let's get it on. Let's do it. Fucking play some Freebird. That is so cute. How is he... Is he sitting on the bench too? Or is he sitting on... It doesn't even matter. Tyra Coon was reluctant at first, but after that... His tune was getting better and better. Aw. Free Bird. We said we were doing one song, but we ended up doing many more. Aw, yeah. Whoop, whoop, pull over that ass too fat. Whoop, whoop, pull over that ass too fat. Whoop, whoop. Whoop, whoop. It was so much fun I didn't... Oh, it was so much fun I didn't really count. I'm glad he shared his story with me today, and I'm glad that I could help him. Aww. Oh, find me in the Alp. What's up? Glad he could make it. I read that already. This time, I'm sure he'll be fine. You came in time just to see me freaking seduce this T-Rex, man. This time, I'm sure he'll be fine. Mad Dog Senpai has noticed me. I am noticing you. Get that dino dick. That would... Oh. You know, I just got a mental image, and I'm not even going to address it right now. And the music club performance for this year's cultural event will be just fine. I think so, too. But I'll forget about that for now. Right now, I want to enjoy this moment with Tyra Coon. That's right. Look at how little the little ukulele is. Aw, look at his little sweat droplets and his little blush. Oh my god. I ship me and Tyra Coon. Good end. Yeah, we did it. Okay, he's sitting on a log, I guess. We did it. Yeah, see, I told you it was short. I'm glad every... Hey, Flutteryay, what's up? What's the bad end? Is that game really easy? Yeah, it's pretty easy. It's very short. The bad end, if I recall correctly, is if you really can't fuck up with the hair clip. The way you fuck up is, like, insisting on paying. Then he'll, like, storm off. I don't know what happened. I think the same thing happens if you try to, like, help him pay. You gotta just let him pay for it. And then things get better. And then you have to, you know, say, oh, nothing really. And then you, like, get sexy time. Excuse me. So, yep, that's Jurassic Heart. It's a cute little game. Hi, Bach, I'm dead. Hi, Dad, I'm Mozart. All right, so... Holy shit, there's a lot of people in here. That's awesome. So we'll take a vote. We're done with this. So do you want me to play Hateful Boyfriend or do you want me to play Wario Date? I'm kind of thinking about Wario Date because it's amazing. Birds? What say you all? We'll take a vote.
Wahahaha.
And you've never seen Wario Date? Wario Date? You're torn. Yeah, me too. One is Pigeons, one is Wario. Hateful Boyfriend. It's a pigeon dating sim, I guess. You gotta have Wario. Wario Date's probably shorter, yeah. Yeah, let's go with Wario Date. Let's go with Wario Date. Let me pull it up here. Yeah, I think that one is kind of long too, so we'll do Wario Date first. Bear with me for just a moment while I get it ready here. And I'll fucking close this shit. It took you like 9 hours? Fuck that shit. I'll probably like do a little bit of it and then like I'll give up or something or I'll intentionally sabotage it. Wario Date. There we go. Turn down the music a little bit. You know, fuck that. I want my own damn music. You want me to keep the music? No, I'm gonna play. Okay. We'll compromise. Romantic Waluigi. Let us play something. What would Wario want to listen to? I think this one. Careless Whisper. We can add that to the thing though. I can fucking type. We'll add that to the thing. I hear you calling. Here I come, baby, to save you. I like Wario. Joystick. I don't think you actually need fucking a joystick for this shit. Anyway, is there an evil Peach? I don't know. Let me pull this over here a little bit and I'll get. Oh shit. Are you ready for this shit? So basically, in this game, you're Wario. And like, as you can see here, you have to choose between love or money. So you can either. You know, go for the peen, or you can go for money. Why can't we just have both? All right, let's get this started. Hopefully this doesn't crash. You wanted to date Wario? I know. That would have been cool. Wario House Mushroom Kingdom. Wahahaha. Aw, yeah, girl. You find yourself on this one rotten day of the many rotten days that compose your life, sitting atop your throne of garlic and enjoying a little TV as you think about all the ways you could ruin lives today. That is me to a T. Hell yeah, he's wearing eyeshadow. Look at that. The cyan eyeshadow just brings out, you know, the good features, whatever those are. Can we date a Goomba? I don't think so. And practicing your patented stinky laugh. You take a break to throw a clove or two into your maw, but before the sound of your chewing drowns out the universe, a particularly appealing line or two catches your ear from the TV. Is it really for me? Of course, darling, all for you. It must have been so expensive, there's no way I could accept this. It was, my entire life savings, but you're worth more than all the money in the world. There's nothing I wouldn't give for you. Aww. He does kind of look like a weird kid thing. Nothing? Nothing. You'd give me all the money in the world? Yes, all of it. All for me? Yes. All because you love me so much? Yes, bitch! Shut up. God, you're so dense, I hate you now. I want to spend the rest of my life with you. Please marry me. Oh, of course. Of course I'd marry you. Oh, sorry. Of course I'd marry you if you love me enough to truly give me all the money I could ever desire. Ellipses. That's a lot of fucking ellipses. I've got it. Love. There's no force more powerful in the world than love. How much money do I desire? All of the money. Love. There's no force more powerful in the world than love. Sounds like the perfect way to scam some chumps out of all their money. Wahaha. It's perfect. No one will ever see it coming. Oh, how I love being evil. I relate with Wario here. I think we'd get along. There are some things you should know before playing. You have the option of prioritizing two things, love and money. Making people fall for you is a great way to make money. Don't I know? But it can also have its costs. Lose sight of the gold and you'll end up broke. But on the other hand, if you'd rather give up riches for a life with your sweetheart, there's also an option. Oh yeah, there we go. Aw, yeah. Good timing on the song. If you decide to risk it all on love, then keep in mind that your heart may get broken. T-Rex-san. At almost any point in the game, you'll have the option of leaving the conversation and returning home. Oh, sweet. Just like in real life. Like, you know what, we're done, I'm going home. If you do this, you'll take all your money with you, but you won't be able to contact them again. Your wallet and your heart are both very fragile. Don't I know it? Please treat them with care. Now let your destiny unfold. You hop off your garlic pile and waddle over to the telephone. Now let's see who to scam. Alright. Which should I choose, you guys? Mario, Luigi, Waluigi, Bowser, a foreign specialist? Check the power radar or call it a day. Waluigi? Yeah. Waluigi? Bowser? Loogie? Loogie? Let's go with Waluigi. That guy will do anything I say. I'm dedicating this part to Montana Trucker here. That guy will do anything I say. I better get him on board before anything else. You dial his number. I'm never gonna dance again. Wait. Hey, fucker. Click, thump. Oops. Huh? Waluigi? Suddenly you hear a knock at your door. Ellipses. You go answer it. Who's gonna be the big spoon? I think surprisingly, Waluigi would be the big spoon. Because, like, deep inside, like, well, Wario acts like a badass and shit, and he, like, hates everybody, but secretly inside, he just wants somebody to hold him and tell him that everything's gonna be okay. You feel me? That's right. Alright, is Waluigi sweating profusely with his hands on his knees? Pant, pant, you, pant, pant, needed me, wheeze, cough. Yeah, come in. You step back to let him room to get in. I think so too, Colonel Silver. I think he is too. This is all moving so fast. You probably shouldn't ditch Waluigi today. You have to maintain a certain level of commitment with him, so... I would never ditch Waluigi. Cause they emo. Best to see it through to the end. I agree. Okay. They had a makeover sleep party. Okay. Help me choose. What took you so long, or do you need some water? Do you need some vodka? I thought so too. Do you need some water? Huh? Oh, look it. That's adorable. Huh? Yeah. Do you want the D? Maybe offer him a Bloody Mary? Yeah. You hand him a glass, he chugs it pretty quickly. So, what did you need? Herm. Perhaps you could use him to get money from others. He already does a lot for you, so that should be easier. But if you want him to like it, and you, then it's probably a good idea to treat him fairly, I guess. Waluigi does look like Sporticus. Fucking Sporticus. But that might not get you all the money you want either. Fuck. What to do? Better shoot for love, yeah, I think so. I think Waluigi would be a good choice. Are they brothers? You know what? Just for the sake of, like, not having bad thoughts. Bowser's got mad cash, yeah. Waluigi is a simple man who lives for sport. Yes! We're gonna make some money today. What? Money? Oh, that's a good impression. Yeah, money. What is this? Oops. Oh. Oh yeah, I like this song. You've never let me help you make money before. What? Of course I have. It always just a sports trophy or something. Waluigi is secretly a penguin. You have all those other friends to help you make money. Yeah, well. Okay. Sweeter than you. Sweeter than you. Help me make a decision. I need you this time. Yeah. I need you this time. I'm like my sister goes, we are what the father. The only one, you're my everything. He does sound like a penguin.
Yes.
Yes. Anyway, we're gonna get me rich tonight. Fuck yeah. Right, you. Yes! Aw. We'll make it rain on Waluigi, it'll be cool. Sexual eruption? I may just do that. Okay. First of all, give me all your money. We're gonna go scam some toads. What should I choose? I think I know what you're gonna choose. Scam toads? Yeah. We're gonna go scam some toads. Toads? Fucking toads.
Yeah.
I love the voices in this. Those stupid losers will fall for anything. Alright. You step outside with Waluigi behind you. So, Toad Town then.
Yes.
Waluigi stands silently waiting for something. What? I think we all know what you're gonna choose, but what should I choose? Let him on my hog or tell him to walk? Hog. You hop on your hog and pat the seat behind you. Come on, ride with me. Whoa. Boss hog on candy?
Yeah.
Really?
Wahoo!
Yes, now grab my sides and straddle my hog. Oh yeah, girl. Too big to straddle. Yes. Betaruga, is that you? Maybe. Or it's me in another universe. Whoa, weird. Oh yeah, straddle that shit. He's never gotten to ride your hog before. Maybe we're the same person, maybe. Okay. If I can type today, that would be great. Sipping on gin and juice, laid back. Really? Let's see. There we go. We'll add that to the fucking playlist here. Whoa. He lifts the leg over one side and grabs your love handles. There we go. Oh, fuck. Listen, feel it vibrate. Wow. Oh, by the way, I've seen this go with Waluigi and, like, it gets real. It gets real, so if we make the right choices, we'll get some real shit. Waluigi's knees stick out way too far and hits some road signs on the way. Owie. He yelps in pain with each one, but that's not really your fault, so whatever. You arrive at Toad Town. We got work to do. Kiss the boo-boos. The voices are awesome. Are you sure we should pick on the little toads? Fuck yeah, we should. Of course, what do they care? They're all too stupid to know what they're missing. You look around the plaza for an easy target. Blue toad, purple toad, pink toad, or red toad? Mario is huge in more ways than one. Pink Toad? Purple Dick Toad? I gotta go with Purple Dick Toad. How about that one? Sigh. Be quiet, let's go. The two of you walk over to the purple toad. So red it's purple. He's standing on top of a crate and peering into a window. What's he doing? Heck if I know. Hey, you, Toad, what are you doing? Huh? He turns around to look at you. Who are you? That's not important. What are you doing? Does someone rich live here? This is my house, and I wouldn't say I'm rich, but... Then what are you doing? Oh, well... Look like Krillin. My name's King Booty. Oh, girl. King Booty? Okay, that's my new name. One of my many names. Write that down. King Booty. Yes, King Booty. It's not actually my birth name. I had it changed. I relate with this purple thing. They don't let you get rid of the T, so I figured it wasn't doing any harm. I'm King Boo's number one fan. King Boo, eh? He's so cool. He really is. A little scary, but that's part of his charm. I can get behind that. I'm the founder of his fan club. It's still just me, though. So, what are you doing, then? I bet he has a King Boo body pillow. I bet he does, too. The real question is, why don't I have one? Oh, I think my house might be haunted. So I'm waiting to see if a Boo comes out. Then maybe I can convince them to take me to King Boo. Haunted, eh? Let me take a look. You climb up on the crate and peer through the window. Ellipses. Nothing seems off about it. Been summoning demons. I can imagine like a whole bunch of toads just like trying to summon Satan or whatever. Fucking toads, man. Tell you what, King Booty. Okay, I'll look around or we'll look around. First response I see, I'm gonna go with. Good question. Will? I don't know. I don't remember. I guess we'll see. We'll go look around. Huh? What do you mean? We're experts on ghosts, yeah. Isn't that right? Oh, shit. Aw, yeah, girl. Their expressions with this song is great. Gonna get busy in your house. The more the memer. Oh, I would too, definitely. Huh? Oh, yeah. So let us poke around and we'll let you know if we've got a ghost. Ghost on your hands. Do it on the piano? Maybe. Is it the haunted piano from Mario 64? You'd be banging. Really? You do that for me? Sure, why not? Wow, thanks. There's one thing though. What is it? Don't look. At all. No matter what. Oh, okay, that makes sense. They are shy after all. And you are the experts, yes. Just let us inside and we'll let you know. Yeah, go ahead inside. I feel bad. I a little bit feel bad for him, but... Doing it and doing it round. Oh, yeah. I'm now imagining Waluigi and Wario, like, doing it to this song, and... I'm not sure if I'm repulsed or aroused. Maybe a little bit of both, I'm not sure. Excellent! Wahaha. You both walk inside and shut the blinds on King Booty. Was gonna call this a live audience, but ghosts. It's just ectoplasm? Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Waluigi turns the light on. So, what's the plan? Steal things or wait it out? I'm kind of leaning more towards wait it out. Ectogasm. Oh, man. Wait for what, though? Well, like, wait it out, and then, I don't know, somehow convinced Booty to, like, give us shit instead of just stealing the shit. Maybe we'll get more shit. And maybe we'll get to have sex with King Booty. You know what I mean? Don't stop. I got a plan. Don't do anything yet. If you say so. You wait around in the house for a few minutes before heading out. King Booty perks up when you exit. Well, did you find anything? Yep, you definitely got something in there. Waluigi has longer arms than Slenderman, yeah. Get a crazy orgy going? Oh, hey, Wiggly. Fluffy Bear Trap just decided to show up. And sit right in front of my monitor, too. Good, because I didn't want to look at it anyway. You're trying to keep me from sitting, aren't you? Well, it's not gonna work. It's not gonna work. You can't keep me from sinning, bro. You're so cute, though. Look at you. Look at you. Aw, you're a good kitty. Move, though. Please. Please. Thank you. Thing is, there's no way to get it to come out like this. We will have to take all our clothes off to get the ghost out. Huh? Oh, shit. Yeah, like you said, they're too shy. Oh, no. But I've got some bait for you right here. Pull something out of right pocket. Pull something out of left pocket. Pull something out of Waluigi's pocket. Uh-oh. Either way, we're playing pocket pool here. Waluigi's pocket? Okay. You reach into Waluigi's pocket. What? Hey. You pull out his dick. Eyeliner. Alright. I can imagine that. Hey, that's my... Be quiet. This. Whoa. Will that really work? Gimme. Nuh-uh. What? Dick rolled out like an accordion? Long dong. That's what I'm talking about. It's gonna cost you. You see? That's why I wanted to wait it out, man. How much? 300 coins. If it'll help me meet King Boo, deal. He takes the bait. Literally. Pleasure doing business with you, King Booty. Two wieners? Your mom lets you have two wieners? Fuck yeah. Double fish this shit, man. Pleasure doing business with you, King Booty. No thank you. Yee-hee-hee, I can't wait to try it. Just remember, it may take a little while. Okay. King Booty rushes inside. You, gonna share some of that money? What should I do? Don't give him money. I think we should give him, some. I don't know how much to give him. All? A little? All or a little? Half? Okay. We'll compromise. Starry. So he loves you all. No, half is good. I'll go with half. I wonder what he'll say if I give him all of it, though. That way he can take me on a date. Fuck it, I'm giving all. You give him all 300 coins. He seems totally astounded that you would ever do that. Alright, let's move on to the next one. I guess we did kind of give away his eyeliner. That shit's expensive. I don't know how much that is in, like, Mushroom Kingdom, but it's probably pretty. Now he can buy all the eyeliner he wants. Yeah, he can even get cyan eyeliner to match. Okay, blue toad, pink toad, red toad. Blue? Blue, red. I do not know what the duck, the hair was doing in your mouth. I hate it when that happens, though. Okay, I need one more. Blue or red? Or pink? I cannot make decisions. You need to tell me what to do. And then you tell me what to do, and I just kind of do whatever. Pink, alright. I'll go purple, pink. We have two blues, we'll go with blue. Let's try that over there. The two of you walk up to a blue toad who's huddled up against the wall, facing away from you. Aw. Hey, what's up? Oh, I remember this one. Okay, this one's gonna be good. No response. Hey, you. He jerking it? While crying? That's what I'm talking about. That's a good time. That's a typical Saturday night for me, I'll tell you what. Still nothing. Hey, bozo. What? What are you doing? The toad sighs. Nothing. She returns to sulking as though you've never been there. Yell at her. Get Waluigi to deal with it. The classic gamer. Yell at her or get Waluigi to deal with it. Yeah, that's definitely something I would do.
Loser.
Hey, loser, turn around. She doesn't listen. I'm talking, Dumbo. Look at me, Shroom Lord. Let me try. Waluigi kneels down and puts a hand on the toad's shoulder. Wiggly. This is more than a crush. Waluigi kneels down and puts a hand on the toad's shoulder. Hey, are you okay? The toad looks up at him. She is sniffing the microphone right now. Please don't sit on the modem. Thank you. The toad looks up at him. No. You want to talk about it? Can you help me? Wow, you never realized that Waluigi was so fatherly. Aw, yeah, girl. He looks so mature right now. Yeah, maybe. What's your name? Teal Toad. What? Teal? Teal Toad. I don't know, still looks blue to me. You need to have babies with him? I know, we really do. So what's the matter? Well, it's about my girlfriend. Girlfriend, huh? Yeah. She's supposed to come meet my family tonight for dinner, but... But? I'm nervous. I don't think my family will be nice to her. They get uncomfortable around chain chomps. Can you imagine? You know what? I'm going to leave that to your guys' imagination. If they don't like her, they won't let me see her anymore. I don't know what I'll do if that happens. I love my family, but I don't want to leave her. I don't want to leave them or Eliza Chomp. Okay, I'm changing my name to that. Eliza Chomp. Doshio? Eh? A chain chomp, huh? Give me money. That'll fix things, or you gotta lie. Okay, you gotta help me out with this. I would go towards money, the lying part, because who doesn't like to lie? Money solves all problems. Okay, we'll go with money. Give me mo. Waluigi slaps his hand over your mouth. Whoa, looks like he slapped his hand on something else. That's not going to work. Well, obviously she has to lie, right? Lie? I don't want to lie to my family. Well, not for a long time. What do you mean? Alright, this is genius, so listen up. First, you disguise a lizard chump as a toad. Then, after your family already likes her, reveal the truth. They'll thank you for helping them get past their preconceptions about chomps. Wow. Way to go, Wario. Do you really think that'll work? Sounds like a good plan to me. Okay, but how should I disguise her? What do you think, Waluigi, or let me tell you? Ask of the Bay. Alright. What do you think, Waluigi? Me? Well, I guess you'd need something like that, cap thing. I have some fungus growing underneath my bike. That might work. And then, do you have any clothes big enough? I have some elastic ones. Waluigi has boobs? Maybe. Moobs. Perfect. That should be more than enough. I'll go get the fungus. Waluigi will go get the fungus. Oh, this is my jam right here. Oh, yeah, girl. Waluigi gets the fungus or I get the fungus? I think Waluigi should get the fungus. Waluigi will go get the fungus. Go on, get it. Whoa. Dat hot fungus. Waluigi walks off to scrape the fungus from your hog. Now let's discuss the matter of our bill. Aw, I don't have a lot of money. What? Well, you better, because my price is 1,000 coins. 250. Huh? 250. What? No, 200. No? 100? You're fine. God damn it. Waluigi returns with the nasty shrooms. Fungus from your dick? Hog fungus. Here you go. Thank you both so much. I'm gonna go grab the clothes and tell her about the plan right now. Wahaha, perfect. Teal Toad runs off. Do you think what we did was right? Huh? It might not actually work. Do you think we just ruined anything for her? They had to find out eventually. The more you worry about your family's approval, the worse off you'll be when you need to make yourself happy. Whoa. That's deep, Wario. In the end, I think they'll know what the right choice is. Wow. If their family can't accept their happiness, then good riddance. Wise words. You can't keep people like that around you all the time. It isn't healthy. Word. Wow. That's deep, Wario. No shit. You fucking farted. No. Who next? Pink Toad, Red Toad. Nah, I didn't miss out on anything. Did the cat poop? No, that was Waluigi. Fluff is sitting on the arm of the couch right now, so she's distracted. Just the giant purple dick. Pink Toad, Red Toad. It really doesn't matter about pink. That one seems gullible. What makes you say that? They're all gullible. What? Eat my meat. The two of you walk up to the pink toad who's standing in front of a grill on top of a cute little stool. He is a gangster. Hey, you. What? What's your name? T-Bone. Fuck yeah. T-Bone? Yeah, T-Bone, what? Oh, having any trouble? Does it look like I'm having trouble? You both look him up and down. Well, no, because I'm not. So what do you want? Just wondering what you're doing. I'm making some damn steaks. My name's T-Bone, and I'm grilling some fucking steaks. I'm standing on this adorable little fucking stool and drilling some goddamn steaks on this motherfucking barbecue cuts too tall for me, and my name's T-Bone. Alright. Are we done here? Confer with Waluigi or keep trying? Confer. You pull Waluigi aside to discuss your game plan. How are we gonna crack this guy? Are these Steam games? I don't know if they're on Steam. I just happened to find and download this one. I got nothing. Me need. Wait. I got it. Just follow my lead, okay? I'm gonna go ahead and follow his lead. Hey, you mind if we stick around and try your steak out? What even is this? This is Wario Date, is what it is. Of course. Meat men such as myself live only to share our meat with anyone seeking a fine slab of beef. Also wise words to live by. Here, this one's done already. T-Bone flips open the grill and tosses a steak towards Waluigi. Eat it midair or let the meat fly. Let the meat fly. I'm gonna let that meat fly. You don't intercept the meat's trajectory in the slightest. Waluigi takes a bite. T-Bone looks pretty confident. This isn't very good. Whoa. Oh no, meat in your face. Yeah, I don't know, not feeling it. You're full of it, man. That hunk of beef is grilled to perfection. No, wait, here, you try. He offers you the hunk and you don't hesitate to chomp the whole thing at once. I'm following his lead, so is Petri. He gonna get T-boned. See? I don't know. I might have to call somebody about this. This meat is seriously subpar. No, don't! Them's is fighting words. Why shouldn't I? I'll pay you. Pay? Here, take this 400 coins. It's all I have. Please, don't sully my rep. I guess that's fair. Yeah, that's fine. Everyone makes mistakes. Pay for the dick. Where is the sex? Okay, we'll get to the sex. Don't worry, we'll get to it. Thank you. I promise this won't happen again. Did he just fart? T-Bone nervously hops on top of his barbecue, pulls the lever, and drives it into a nearby... Okay. Aww. You hear a loud bang and some sobbing. Well, he was kind of a dick, so... Wow. Impressive. Don't worry, we'll get to that. We'll get to the sex in a minute. You walk towards the red-tailed girl sitting at a tiny table. There's plates and teacups set up. Everything is really frilly. On either side of her are little toad dolls sitting in tall, small chairs at the table. She looks up at both of you in the middle of sipping what is probably tea. May I help you? Yeah. Got room for two more? She looks you both up and down very critically. You may sit. You both sit in the two remaining chairs. Oh, she fancy. Waluigi's legs pop up over the table and your chair creaks beneath you. Your name's Wario. Waluigi, charmed. I am tea time. Please help yourselves to some tea. Tea time. Fucking. Tea time. Don't do that. My name is not to be spoken unless you intend to address me. All right. Sorry. Bitch. You both pour your tiny cups with a little bit of tea and take a sip. Fart or resist the urge to fart? Now that is a decision. Fart? Don't fart. Alright. Release it. You stopped that or I'll have you removed.
Sorry.
Sorry. Who are your friends? I'm delighted you asked. She reaches over and picks up the tow doll on your left. This is Ruti. Then she grabs the one on your right and holds it up next to the other. And this is Tuti. Say hello. She has them both wave at you. Hey. Hi. She puts Ruti down and holds Tuti up closer to you. Nice to meet you. She puts Tuti down and does the same with Ruti. She has issues. Thank you both for joining us. Yeah, no problem. Ruti, Tuti, could you please stop slouching in front of the guests? I'm doing no such thing. Why don't you make sure to drink your tea a little bit more quietly? That's highly rude. The nerve. I apologize profusely for my sister's errant behavior. Please, let's not argue. I'm not. R2, be quiet. how are we gonna... I have an idea. Okay. You reach into one of your back pockets and start rustling. Hey, ladies, please, stop fussing. Scammer for everything she's got. I'm gonna try. I want you both to meet my friend. Wait, what? You pull out a toad doll of your own. It seems are coming apart, and it probably has been used as a napkin on more than one occasion. Meaty. Where did you get that? Nowhere. Aw, he blushing. Oh. Pleased to meet your acquaintance, Meaty. Yes, charm. Tell me about yourselves or fart. Penis. Fart. I don't know, man. She told us if we farted again. Yeah, I'm gonna go with tell me about yourselves. That way you can hurry up and get the money and get to the sex. Yes, both of us, truly. We may argue, but we'd never doubt one another's elegance on stage. Isn't that right, sister? Quite right. Without ween? This tea is great. You are quite the charmer, Meaty. I should say so. I think Meaty's gonna end up having sex before I do. And such lovely china. And such lovely china. Hee hee, thank you. You have fine taste, Meaty. So I have a proposal for you two. I'm sorry, Mr. Meaty, but I prefer you not haggle with... No tea time, it's alright. Yes, let the man speak. Very well. What is your offer, Meaty? A special exfoliating recipe. Do tell. Whoa, I'm reaching in my pockets a lot and grabbing shit. You reach into your pocket and pull out some barbecue sauce? Yeah. I heard that a Bob-omb mom found out the secret of this stuff. Just put a little on your cheeks and chin every night before you go to sleep. It'll work its magic on its own. Sounds like fucking shit I'd read on damn Tumblr. Wow, that's incredible. Astounding. Where can we get some of this? Yeah, or barbecue sauce. All over your mouth. It's very rare. You can't get it many places. But I'll be willing to sell you it for 500 coins. That's deal. We're making money, bro. Waluigi is just staring into my soul. Excuse me? Oh, please, it's so rare. Fine, you two will run me dry. Here you are. Time hands the money to you. Well, to me, T. Pleasure doing business with you. Yes, you as well. And your two friends. Hee hee hee. Hee hee hee. Now, if you'll excuse me, I must have a chat with my two sisters here. You keep a straight face Hey, sitting on the counter, I wanna play. Checking out the moves that you display. You got me right open.
Oh yeah.
It is a complicated plot. When you wanna play. Not bad, hee hee hee. Who's next? That's all of them. Okay, now we're gonna get real right now. How can you tell? You slap your belly. Whoa, I can feel it. So we're done? Yeah. You're hearing some tunes. This is, Bootsy Collins right now. You got me wide open. Stepping, just push and shove. You wanna head home and count it all with me? Fuck yeah. You wanna head home and count it all with me? Yeah. Let's call it a day. Alright, home alone. Feel like making love. You both hop on your bike and make for your place. You both step inside your home. Excuse me. Count all his dicks. Come back for coffee. Yeah. You're reminded that Waluigi is really one of the only people who can visit without visibly gagging at either the sight or the smell. That always meant a lot to you. Word. He takes a seat on your couch. What a day, eh? Yeah, no kidding. You know, Wario, something felt different today. Their farts are compatible. And your hips.
Yeah.
I felt it too. I'm glad. So then you know what I mean. Oh, fuck. Be true. You've always stepped on me whenever we worked together. I never really felt like we were an actual team, but today, it seemed like you turned that around, you know? We're gonna get sexy time. I would ask you what to do, but I think we all know what we want to see. I'm glad you noticed. So you were trying. Yes. It means a lot to me. You said some things earlier, and, well, if things today had counted as continued as normal, I'd probably left. I'm glad you didn't, then. Me too. He puts a hand on your knee. Oh, fuck. Hang on. We gotta, choose something more appropriate. Let's see. I think we need... Aw, yeah. We're gonna get down. He looks you square in the eyes. Put your hand on his thigh. He smiles softly at you. You're the most important person in my life, Wario. Aww. I don't have anyone without you. I'm gonna fucking cry. I'm gonna fucking shed tears right now. Freaking with you.
Don't you understand? I wanna be your nasty man.
I know you have a lot of other friends, but... Pity sex? You'll always have a place in my heart. I think so too. You'll always have a place in my heart. He smiles a little wider. Do you mean that? Yes. I mean before I met you. before that first tennis tournament over a decade ago. I wish MT was here so bad. I didn't know what I was doing. I tried to be evil, but it didn't really work out. I was too awkward. Then you introduced me to Luigi, and well, the rest is history, I suppose. But the point is, I wouldn't be who I am today without you. So thank you. You were plenty evil before I showed up. That's not what I mean. I mean, I'm thankful to have you. We're gonna do it. You can't just jump the gun. That means a lot, thank you. Well, I guess we should start count. You pay. You place a finger over his lips. He quiets down. Okay. Fiercely, I'm thinking the same thing. I told you it got real. I told you it got real. Oh, shit. I won't break it with you. You leap up and suddenly smack your lips onto his. He's initially surprised, but quickly his face turns red and he settles down. You push him down on the couch, laying on top of his torso and sucking your open mouth on his. He reaches his hands up and puts them on your sides. It gets intense pretty quickly. It feels very rough and passionate, with a lot of heat swapped between the two of you. Waluigi rolls you over and you land on the floor, him on top of you. I hope somebody's masturbating while I'm reading this. For a brief moment, you look up at him, looking wild and thirsty for something. But before you can process it, he pushes his mouth down again and you're stuck squirming underneath him. I know somebody wants to do fan art of this shit. You feel your mustaches twirling together. Greasing each other up. They tug and pull and grope until you can feel the roots of your lips threatening to explode. Everything feels hot. Just before you finally feel like you can't breathe, he lifts his head up, panting. You stare at each other for a while. Slowly, something in Waluigi's eyes shift, and you can tell he snapped out of something. What? Oh my god, I'm sorry, I didn't know what... It's okay. No, what was I... H... You put a finger to his lips and smile. It was nice. Are you sure? Yeah. He looks down at you sadly, smiling. I love you, Wario. I love you too, Waluigi. Can we... Oh, fuck. Can we stay like this? Just a little while longer? Sure, but... Let's take it back to my room. Oh, yeah. Good song choice. The floor is a little hard, Yes, good idea. He lifts you off the ground and holds you in his arms, bridal style. His arms are so warm. He plants a kiss on your forehead and carries you to bed. Tonight you'll sleep well in the arms of your one and only two partner. The end. Wow. That was amazing. Do you guys like that? Do you guys like that? I really like that. The only thing I could probably ask is more like art during the sex shit, but you know, you can't have everything. And I didn't pay anything for this game, so I mean, can't really ask for much. Do you guys want to play again, or do you want to play the pigeon one? Pigeons? Pigeon? Pigeons? Again? We'll probably go with pigeons just so that we can play everything. And then if I fail horribly at pigeons, which I probably will, then we can do, like, we can date Bowser or something. But I'm gonna go have a break for a minute. I will be right back in about 5 minutes. So please enjoy this wonderful music, and I will return right back. You need sleep? All right. I don't blame you. It's probably late where you guys are. Thanks for stopping by, Alps. I appreciate it. Yeah, we'll take a break, go to the bathroom, masturbate, whatever you gotta do. I'll be back in about 5 minutes, all right? Wiggly, don't you fuck with my computer.
Harlem at the Ruckers, yeah. I saw you with your man, smiling, huh, a coach bag in your hand, I was laying in the coop with my hat turned back, we caught eyes for a moment, and that was that, so I skated off, as you strolled off, looking at them legs, goddamn, they look so soft. I gotta take you from your man, that's my mission. If his love has really got to handle competition, you only knew him 5 months.
That's right.
Besides, he drink too much and smoke too many blunts. And I be working out every day thinking about you. Looking at my own eyes in the rear view. Catching flashbacks of our eye contact. Wish I could lay you on your stomach and caress your back. I would hold you in my arms and ease your fears. I can't believe it, I ain't had a crush in years. Hey, love. Relationship, so I look back in the cut with a crush. Still, he can't stop having daydreams, tonguing you down with vanilla ice cream, kissing on your thighs under moonlight, searching your body with my tongue, girl, all night. I wonder one day could it be simple dreams could turn into reality. Our love would come down so naturally. We would walk down the aisle of destiny. Watch your man get his hustle on, got your type scared. Make you off a little chump change to do your hair. That seems to be enough to satisfy your needs, but there's a deeper level if you follow our lead.
All right, welcome back. You gotta go to the club. I understand that. Dance some pirate dances for me. All right.
I saw your
Alright, so. Excuse me. Oh, yeah, Pyro Dance. Yes, I am sure. Let me open up our last game for tonight. That's not what I want. How did I get this to work? Undying passion unites our souls. Together we swim until the point of no control. But it's a fantasy, you won't come true. We never even spoke in your man's way, love you. So I'ma keep all these feelings aside. That's right. Keep my dreams alive until the right time. There we go. Is this loading or what? Your lips, your this was being fucking English. Let me try it again here. By the pigeon and for the pigeon. Oh shit, I didn't even do that, fuck. There we go. Don't date the doctor. Do this shit. Please enter your name. Wait, what? I wasn't paying attention. I fucked up. Fucked up. Mad dog. I said mad dog. Hang on, let me fuck this up. Okay. Last name. Dog. Dog. fucked that up. Dong mad. Okay. It doesn't matter. Fuck it. The cast was released on April Fool's with the voice credits. This game doesn't have voices, though. Sorry. That's alright. Don't need to hear shit. It does, however, have an advanced ICPSS built in. Intracerebral Playback Synchro System. What the fuck? The name of each character's voice actor will be displayed when they are introduced. VA freaks, please imagine those actors' voices. The thing also includes a powerful visualization module, allowing even the birdiest of birds to appear as normal humans when first introduced. Alright. Display human portraits? Yeah, whatever. Configuration saved. Right click to show a menu of more options such as graphics, whatever. Saint Pigeonations, a school blessed with extensive curricula and facilities. It's already been a year since I ended my ordinary life and walked through these gates. I should probably stay. This school is known for one thing in particular. Good dick. This school is the world's greatest gathering place for gifted birds. Am I also a bird? Birds who want to study the arts, the sciences, even sports, all come to St. Pigeonations. The teaching staff and student body are both made up of diverse blend of birds of different backgrounds and species. I'm often asked why I chose to come here despite not being a bird. Okay, I'm not a bird. It's a long story. Not every day I see you rushing along like this. Ryota. Usually you'd have been ready an hour by now, Matt. Overslept? Oh, he's hot. This rock dove is named Kawara Ryota. We've been friends since he was barely hatched. Peanut butter. He can be a bit mischievous, but he's responsible and kind. Breakfast was a little hard to catch today. I can't relax without red meat inside. Oh, yeah, girl. Living as a hunter-gatherer sounds tough. I'd be happy to make you breakfast, you know. I might take you up on that offer when starvation looms. Thanks, Ryota. Aw, shit. Time to go to fucking school, I guess. Oh, the bell already? Come on, we need to hurry to class. Jeepers! No good being late on the first day. And so, Ryota pulled me along into the school. Today is the start of a new semester. I wonder what lies in store. It was all I could do to adjust to the atmosphere last year. Better make up for all that last fun. Would help if I could talk. The most splendid and gifted, greatest academy of the pigeon, by the pigeon and for the pigeon. All right. I think we're in 2-3. Ryota and I are in the same class again. Old faces, new faces, a strange thrill fills my heart as I look around at the assembled birds. I hope we all get along. Here's to the formation of many happy memories. Oh, the teacher's here. Good morning, every birdie. I'm Nanaki Kazaki. I'm butchering these names, I don't care. I seem to be your teacher this year. I specialize in math and physics, and also some other things. Sir, wake up, it's homeroom. He sleeps with his eyes open? Holy fuck. You don't want to know how I misread any faces? I think I do. This quail is Nanaki Kazaki. You know what? Fuck it. He's a famously sophomoric math professor. I've heard the rumors, but I hadn't expected him to fall asleep just like that. Apparently, he's well known as a mathematician. Just goes to show, great minds come in all forms. I'm sorry, isn't it a little warm in here? Which reminds me, we have a transfer student. Please introduce yourself, Shirogane. Whoa, that's fancy as fuck. What is the point? I have no wish to speak with commoners. Do not think I'm here because I wish to be. Oh, well, I guess that's that. What a fucking bastard. Hey, that's no good. But he doesn't want to introduce himself. But we can't just let him break the rules like that, sir. The system will collapse and we'll all turn into Kulakian dissenters. I don't know what that means. To Sandra. Well, when you put it like that, could you at least say your name, Shirogane? Ellipses. Shirogane Libel Sakura. Sakuya. Holy fuck. I'm gonna fuck you. I'm gonna fuck you. It seems this fantail is Shirogane Sakuya. His feathers would make any birdie proud. He's pretty stuck up, but then transferring is never easy. I hope we can be friends. More than friends. Sayuka sits down, glaring daggers at Ryota and me. I think this little bird is telling me there's going to be trouble down the line. Lunch already. Today is slipping by so quickly. That reminds me, I've had these books out from the library all summer. I'll return them now. Oh, the librarian is going to be hot. Maybe, I don't know. Where is everyone? Aside from the receptionist, there's hardly any birdie here. Huh? Is someone looking at me? Probably just my imagination. Voyeurs. Well, that's a pretty one. Or not. A mourning dove stands in the dark corner staring in my direction. A mourning dove? Is this a goth? Mourning doves aren't very common in Japan, but apparently they're everywhere in America. I don't fucking know. Did you want something from me? He looked away. Not really. Well, don't stare at me, bitch. I'm pretty sure it was him who I felt looking at me. There's no one else here. Are you sure? Yes, I don't want anything with you. Well, fuck you too. Half dead motherfucker. It's the things you're carrying that I'm interested in. He glances at the desk as if to say, hurry up and return them already. Oh, sorry, Ihi. They were a little too dense and I never finished them. Were you waiting for them all summer? He silently returns his gaze to his book. Maybe he's in a bad mood. I'm dong mad, a sophomore. What about you? Your Nageki. Fujishiro Nageki. Bed mood? Yeah, we'll get to that. Freshman. Mourning doves are pretty rare in Japan. Maybe it's just his voice, but he seems kind of sad. Aw. Leave me alone. Well, fuck you too, punk. He's reading his book again. Fuck your book. I'm gonna dump that book on the ground. I'm gonna push you out that window. Bitch. Okay, sorry to bother you. I keep meeting depressing people today. Just like real life. Now that I have that out of the way, I think I'll head back to class. Wait, isn't that... You should have been instructed not to approach me in school. Come on, Sakia, what kind of thing is that to say to your own brother after all these years? Is his brother hot too? My brother, you must be joking. You've never once been a brother to me. Please don't talk to me again. I've no time for half-breeds. I'll be going now. Wow. Hey, wait just a... Oni-chan. I guess even if we're in the same school now, what's done is done. I hadn't meant to eavesdrop, but I think I just overheard something juicy. Aw, yeah, girl. The ever-popular trendsetter and ladies' man, Sakazaki Yuya, is Saki's brother. I wonder what the story behind that is. Hey, what? You heard the whole thing, right? Are you a friend of Sakia's? I'm sorry. I didn't mean to listen in on you. Haha, no sweat. I try to stay sexy and suave in front of all you little ladies, but that wasn't so too cool. Alright. Oh, he's hot too. This fantail pigeon is Sakazaki Yuya, an upperclassman. Oh shit. But fuck your brother and you. I've never talked to him before, but he's famous or infamous throughout the school. Everyone knows of him. Why is he wearing barrettes? Oh well. You're mad, right? I am mad, all right. How did you... I know every birdie here. Besides, you're the only human... Yeah, I kind of stick out. A single poppy in a field of rye. Oh. Surprising lack of English in this game? Yeah. Did a pretty good job. Did you say you were a friend of... I wanna freak you. You say you were a friend of Sakia's? Not exactly. We had a rather ballistic introduction this morning. We're in the same class, that's all. I'd never thought the stuck-up aristocrat wannabe was your brother. Aristocrat wannabe. He is an aristocrat, actually. The genuine article in the flesh. He is? He's a bit of a pain, so good luck, mon ami. Adieu. Oh, he's French and shit? He really is a noble bird. I've never heard anything like that about Yuya, though. Probably a twisty business? I don't know. April 8th? Oh, shit, there's dates? I wasn't paying attention. You going straight up do that bird? I'm gonna do all these fucking birds, man. The babies will look like tar and feathered trolls. that's all for today. Stay safe, everyone. What are we doing? Yay. Huh? Sir, where's Ryota? He said he was going to the infirmary. Maybe you should go see if he's still there. Smack each bird with your dick. I'm gonna. Eat it. The early bird gets the worm. Now that I think about it, Ryota always did have a weak stomach. Maybe I should go to the infirmary just to make sure he's okay. No birdies here? There's no one sleeping behind the curtains, and the doctor isn't here either. My hunter-gatherer instincts feel no presence. There's no birdie here. Ryota? No reply. The infirmary is empty. Weird, did he just go home already? I feel a little nervous poking around an empty room. Now that I think of it, I've never been here much before. Unlike Ryota, I'm perfectly healthy. Well, they've got all sorts of drugs in here. That is something that I would notice. Ethylpar, Trifi, Luciobenzene. What do these even do? Care to find out? Oh, fuck. I'm gonna get drugged. What in the shit? Dick. I'll feed you all sorts of things if you want. Wow. Alright. Alright. No thank you, you fucking perv. Wait, you're hot. This partridge is Iwamine Shu, the school doctor. He's rather creepy in person and has a bad reputation among the student body. Everybody knows that just talking to him can bring you down with Aspergillus Piscicatus or even worse things. Is that like bird herpes? And I never even heard him come in the door. Ninja doctor? Ninja fucking partridge. Partridge family bullshit. Bird her piece it is. I was right. You don't look like you have a good reason to be in here. Did you need something? I heard Ryota Kawara from 2-3 was supposed to be here. Him? He's already gone. Oh. Why didn't he come find me before going home? Oh, you're leaving, Starry? Alright, well thanks for coming by, buddy. I'll see you later. Sorry to bother you. I'll be going now. You fucking creep. Ah, finally got out of that den of evil. Ryota's already gone home. What do I do now? Probably go home. Oh. I never got around to joining a club last year. Maybe I'll go take a look at some of my options. I think there are clubs for baseball, soccer, track, kendo, migration, birdwatching. Wait. Later, Danny. Thanks for stopping by. Wasn't there... Wait a minute. There's a birdwatching club in a bird school. So is it that like a voyeur club or something? You stand around and watch each other? Like creeps? I guess. Wasn't there another one? Anyway, I'll start with the track team. I'm not running. I'm not running for shit. Thug life. I ran in middle school, and it's always funny watching the birds hop around. I think their club room is on the ground floor off to the side. A white dove is having a tantrum outside. Coo coo. This is no pudding for a man. Okay. Coo. Okosan rejects it. It is a lie, a vicious falsification. He's dancing around on a squished pudding. Hey, that's not very nice to the pudding. There's always room for Jell-O. What in the shit? This is Akko-san. He doesn't really look it, but he's supposedly a fantail pigeon, I think. Either way, he's hyper. His persona is too real. Cool. Okosan has suffered a deceptive... most vile, a wretched betrayal. Betrayal? Coup. Okosan instructed that pudding be provided for new members. Coup. But this is no pudding. Ousted, scorned, betrayed, dragged into the street, and shot by those he trusted most. Girls that didn't last. It's squished and filthy. But the thing under his feet looks like normal store-bought pudding. What's wrong with it? Spare the jest, young lady. Okosan, you use wing attack? It's super effective? They'll rue the day they cross Okosan. He'll have them flayed, hang, shot at dawn, he will. Alright. Okosan must now train to achieve true pudding. Farewell. And he's gone. And he's fucking insane. He's a good running, but what does pudding have to do with track team? And so ended the first day of my second semester at St. Pigeon Nations. Achieve true pudding. There's always room for Jell-O. I think we want to choose the class council today. As you all know, this school doesn't require you to join any club. If you want to, you can. But if you don't, then you're free to go home after school. Fuck yeah, I'm gonna go home after school. I had to go home and... jerk it. While thinking about birds. Okosan has time for only the track team. Stop talking in the third person, you fucking weirdo. That's good. What about you, Shirogane? A foolish question. I already hold a position here. Oh, that's right. You became student president when you were admitted. Nepotism, ho. Didn't we get to vote? Just coming to school is enough for me. You have to take care of your mother on your own, after all. And all. I wonder what I should do. Join the... Alright, what should I do? Don't talk to my boyfriend like that, alright. Jerk it to Waluigi Wario. And birds. Library? Yeah, I don't do track team, sorry. Student council for the French bird? Yeah, the library guy's fucking a bastard, so... That's everyone, isn't it? Have fun. April 11th, okay. Today's an elective day. What should I do? Go home. Attend. Math class, gym class, music class. Take over the school. You worked in the library? I don't like math. I definitely don't like gym, so we're gonna do music class. We sang birdie melodies. It was a little tiring, but singing together is fun. You know what would be funny? If these portraits up here were like bird versions of like Bach and Mozart and stuff. let's see. Mad leveled up. Charisma increased by 5. Oh, fuck. I didn't know you could level. I was pretty sure I wanted to join it, but what does the council do again? We skipped the vote, and I think it's only Sakia and me. Oh, I'm stuck with that fucking bastard. It is the D&D of dating. What the fuck? I wasn't prepared. Dating and dying. Please just kill me. Anyway, he called a meeting, so to the council room I go. This looks like a CEO's office. This fucker. Naturally, do you think I would stand for anything less? Oh, this is the jam. So you had this ice hockey, so you had this done? This room used to be filthy. Better suited to the rabbits than to us. What's wrong with fucking rabbits? What a prig. Have you decided which position you will take? I get to choose? Who is there to choose for you? Dumb Japanese? Wow. Aren't you Japanese too, Sakia? Do not mock me, I am French. Wow. Wow, racist. A French noble bird? That sounds delicious. You know what's gonna happen? I'm just gonna end up, like, eating all these birds. The most powerful position is on your knees. Yes. I'm going to fuck them and then I will eat them. That's been my plan all along. Plot twist. I guess I have to pick a post now. I think I'll be the vice president, treasurer, or clerk. Date and devour. Eating them while having sex with them? Whoa, that's a kink. Vice president, treasurer, or clerk? I don't know. I don't think I would be suited for a treasurer. Because I'm bad with money, let's be honest. Vore. Vice Prez? Alright, we'll do that. You wish to be my right wing? Haha. You've got nerve, I like that. I think I just got bonded with. Gosh, he looks pretty happy right now. Praying mantises work like that too, they do. And so I became vice president of the student council. Did I level again? What in the shit? Sitting at home is so relaxing. I live in a cave? On a cliff? Alright, well that's pretty much like me. Oh, tomorrow is the class hike. Should I prepare anything? We won't be going far, so I don't have to. Well, health first. I think I'll have some udon and go to sleep. I'm Piccolo? Our beautiful home, yes.
Piccoli. Bertoli.
Today is the hike. We've stopped for a break on a hillside. Who should I talk to?
Living in a cave down by the river.
Italian piccolo, I do too. Who should I talk to? I can't remember these people. I only know two of these people. I don't remember the other ones. Yo, man. He'll be the least hairy Italian man ever. Who also doesn't eat pasta? I'm gonna talk to Ryota, he's cool. Ryota, let's eat together. Sure, great view, huh? Huh? Is that your lunch, Mad? Yep, it's... I don't know what that is. That's a pretty sad thing to bring on a picnic. No, it's not. A great man once said it's the ambrosia of the gods. But who would Italian Piccolo's greasy mustache intertwine with? Geez, if you eat like that, you'll be dead on the roadside by the time we head back here. I'll share mine. Really? Wow, thanks, Ryota. And so I got to eat half of Ryota's lunch. His cooking is so good. Italian Goku has a classy stash. Are we just gonna have an Italian AU now? Because I want that to happen. Do it. I command you, whoever, do it. We can save the whatever that is in the case of a survival situation. And we'll just eat each other if we're in that kind of a situation. Italian Vegeta. We need it. I know y'all draw. I need Italian Vegeta immediately. Oh, that would be great. Italian DBZ for Halloween. Or Mexican. You could have like a, it's a small world. You could all do like DBZ around the world. That'd be pretty cool. You could have Mexico DBZ. We could have Italian. We could have Ukraine DBZ. Swedish DBZ. DBZ hot Italian party. Yes, Halloween's gonna be great. Anyway, back to this thing. Today's an elective day. What should I do? Attend. Why did... If commies look out as a rockin', don't come a-knockin'. Math or gym? I guess math. I'm not getting this at all. That does sound like me. Maybe you should review the basics a little more, Dong. Yes, sir. Mad levels up. Wisdom increased by 5. Holy shit. I imagine you're all well aware, but the sports festival is right around the corner. Please think about what you'll do. Sports festival? What the fuck is that? You know what? I didn't really do a lot in high schools. I have no idea that people have these things. I basically just, like, smoked pot a lot in high school. And watched a lot of Dragon Ball Z. Sports festival season already. If it were in the fall, it would conflict with the cultural festival, so it's always been in May. Oh my god. May would be a terrible time to have a fall sports festival here. We'd all die. What are you going to do, Ryota? I haven't decided, but probably three-legged race? Some birdie has to. Cool. Oh, Ko-san will handle the marathon. Indeed he will. Please die. You have a lot of stamina, Oko-san. What about you, Sakuya? You can't possibly be expecting me to run in some race, can you? I like him. It's a sports festival. It is a sports festival. Is there an event that doesn't involve running? How about being a cheerleader? Oh, shit. That's what I'm gonna do. The general, in other words, very well, leave it to me. I don't think that's... Also, the first aid team is always shorthanded, so I'm sure they could use the help if anybody... Any birdie still can't decide. Got a lot of stamina, baby. You roll? Me too. I'm not gonna be the... Oh, this is the bomb song. Aw, yeah. Hang on, I'm jamming. It's good for the geese. It's always good for the gander. Oh, Sheila. I'm not gonna be in the medical shit because that creepy doctor is there. Ryota's doing the three-legged race, Okuo-san's running the marathon, and Sakuya is a cheerleader. Yuya might be running the first aid tent. What should I do? I'll have to think about it. I run, but run much slower than a bunch of snails. The snails would definitely outrun me. Today is a sports festival. What the fuck is going on back there? Victory or calorie? And there's knights? Wait, hold up. Hold up. There's jousting at this fest? I'm gonna do that. I never did make up my mind. What should I do? You ooze. Me too. Three-legged race, marathon, cheerleaders, first aid tent, library. You molt across the floor. Alright, I don't know what to do. I don't want to do first aid because I don't want to be with that creepy dude. And I don't think I run. I don't run. We've already established that. Library. I don't want to be with the library. Cheerleader. I'll probably get with that stuck up dude. That's what's probably gonna fucking happen. But I like the dude that I'm friends with too. I'll do cheerleader with it or not. There's something of a crowd around our cheerleaders. I see Sakuya and a brass band. That's overdoing it. I think I saw something similar during the changing of the guard at Buckingham Palace. You're here. You're not cutting any corners, I see. Naturally not. Only the best from Libel. I don't know what that is. Sir, preparations are complete, sir. Your orders, sir. Very well, begin. And so the band begins to play. Where did he get these people? They all look like professionals. Shouldn't cheerleaders be students? You, join in. Okay. I seem to be in charge of the cymbals. One wrong slip and I'll be laughing stock of the playground. Yikes. Playground? Taco Bell has a taco shell made of fried chicken. They recently introduced an item called Naked Crispy Chicken Tacos. But you can only get them in Lost Hills in Bakersville, California. What? Stuck-up dude has a soft and gooey center. We need to go on road trip with these fucking tacos, man. I need that. Yeah, I live right next to California. Let's do this. This dating game dialogue. Saki's conducting is awfully flashy. Is this the LeBel style? I don't know. Fuck if I know. You don't have car, I have car. I will drive and pick you all up and we'll go. And it will totally work out because Reg can make it. Piggyback. We could... And if Reg breaks down, we'll just like assemble a whole bunch of cats and we'll just have a cat-drawn car. And it would be like... Mad Max, only with cats. I don't know what I'm talking about right now, so I'm going to go back to this. The first barrier for all students who make this far is the midterm exam. You live on the other side of the country from me? I don't know about that. Form a tower. I like it. We're getting them back today. Ah, I don't think I did too well. Dong! I'm so glad I chose that. Yes? I don't think you did too badly. Yes? Not too... nope, sorry, you did badly. Fuck! No, try harder next time, okay? I disappointed Mr. Nanaki. I'll have to study more from now on. God damn it. From the festival and the midterm... With the festival and the midterm over, there's nothing to look forward to but summer heat. I know that feel, bro. Doves smell kind of funny when it gets humid like this. Oh, you like this song? Yeah. Operator! Yeah. Midnight Star. Your mom has this on her phone. Operator, this is an emergency. Our sausage is sizzling. Huh? There's a bunch of birds in front of the staff room. What are they doing? Oh, there's Yuya. Yuya, what's going on? Salutations, Mad. Brian won his 7th Pulitzer. Who the fuck's Brian? He gestures at a news clipping on the staff room pinboard. It says, Brian, the first intelligent pigeon, crowned again. Brian? Don't tell me you don't know who he is. I don't. I think I've heard of the name, but... He's the world's most famous blogger. Oh, we gotta get with him. We gotta get with them. He began when birds were barely intelligent. He's a very skilled and insightful writer. We're gonna fuck him. This is the guy. That's the dude for me. Is he hot? He was the one who suggested that the Dove Olympics be called the Pidgeolympics. Is he? We gotta get with him, bro. We gotta go for it. Fuck that stuck up dude. Fuck everybody else. We're gonna go with that guy. He is definitely Mad Dog material. He's extremely influential. The name was adopted right away. Why don't you look him up right now, mon ami? Try Googling Brian Pigeon. Okay. Okay. Uh-oh. Lunch is nearly over. Adieu, Mad. Adieu. I'd better hurry back to class. Hello, everybody. Huh? There's a pile of overturned desks in the middle of the floor? Is it that insane dude that's doing shit? Ryota is overturned next to them. Rock doves, underwings, and bellies are light, so they look pretty different upside down. Can we see the wiener? I mean, wait, what's going on? Okosan and Sakuya are... I look up to see two of them at each other's throats in the corner. I think we might have a diplomatic incident on our hands. What happened, Ryota? Saki was making fun of Okosan. He called him a stupid mongrel who only thinks about imaginary pudding and said he was ashamed to be in the same class. That's terrible. I mean, Okosan is a nutcase and I don't know what he's saying half the time, but he really does like pudding. Alright, I can get behind the pudding loving, you know. I'm laughing. Thinking about us walking across country as a tower. Yes, we must do this. It'll totally work out. Imaginary pudding. Write that down. That'll be a great band name. Imaginary pudding. Be on the bottom. Either way, Okosan kind of went for the jugular and you tried to pull them apart and Okosan used wing attack on you. Yep. We're the only hope now, Mad. Yes. Cuckoo. Okosan will not allow pudding or himself to be ridiculed. He will apologize. You tell me to take back my word, I shall not. A mongrel like you hasn't even the right to speak to me. Okosan is not a mongrel. The battle rages and it looks like Ryota's sacrifice was in vain. I should. Beerus and Wisp band name. Best band name. Okay, something else to draw. Them in a band called Imagineering Pudding. Do it. Alright, should I side with Saki, side with fucking Nutcase, or scold them both? scold them both, because this is fucking bullshit. I don't give a shit about them. Oko-san, calm down. Cool. Do you think Oko-san can calm down after such insults? Well, Mongrel, Dong is on my side. You too, Sokka. You have acted immaturely. What? No more fighting, you two. This... take this for Ryota. Mongrel Dong. Because of them acoustics. I grab them both and hurl them out the window in the courtyard. Yeah, that does sound something I would do. Stay out here and think about what you've done. Jeez. Today is a good day. I feel like I'm shining. I wonder what I should do during break. Go to the store, infirmary, cafeteria. I'm going to the store. I need cigarettes. I really don't need anything, but I'll go to the store. I've never really looked around there before. Am I going to meet some other hot dude? I hope so. The shining? The shining? Yes. All work and no play makes Mad Dog and freaking dull Dong. Well, they've got all sorts of things for sale. Though these nest building materials look like what you find in a human store is trash. My, how mature of you, Monami. Planning to settle down already? What? Oh, it's dude, okay. Yuya. No, that's not it. I'm still a high school student. That may be so, but you know we doves reach sexual maturity within a year of birth? What the fuck? Alright, they do. That seems a little hasty. Oh, that's funny. I'm talking about sex and then between the sheets pops up. Good. That aside, what are you here to buy, Yuya? Your love, of course? Are you whoa, we're not wasting any time. What the fuck? My... Yuya, that's... we're not... I'm not good enough? Oh well, I'll have to try again later. Wait, hold up. Come back. Is this how he talks to every girl he meets? Probably. I'm gonna let it slide, because maybe... I don't know. It's not like it's surprising coming from him. He's going for the Dong, that's right. No one can resist Mad Dong. It's an elective day, what should I do? Attend. Math class, gym class, music class. Well, I did everything else, so I'll go to gym. Calisthenics. Ryota, you're in high school and you still can't do a chin-up? Don't look at me like that. You're making me feel like a failure. Aw, I didn't mean that. Vitality increased by 5. Pigeons can't do chin-ups anyway. How are they gonna do that? Oh well, whatever. In this universe, sure, why not? Today is Tanabata? There's probably a bamboo tree in the plaza this year too. I think I'm gonna make a wish. Ryota is a sweetie. Dude, I'm like pining for all these birds, man. I'm gonna walk away from this game and I'm gonna be turned on by fucking pigeons. Pidgeups. And it's just gonna be weird times ahead for me, man. Fetish unlocked. Well, that's just great. I have enough problems. Well, there's lots here already. Any birdie I know? May mother stay healthy this year, and may my stomach get better, Ryota. Aww. I don't know what that means. Zimopel nies pas francas. Dude. What should I wish for? Conquer the world by force? Rule the world from the shadows? Whoa. I'm torn between the first two, man. I'm gonna rule the world from the shadows. I wish to take the reins of power through clever schemes and rule the world from the shadows. Oh, hello, is that you, Dong? Mr. Nanaki. You should be careful out this late. It can be dangerous for a girl, you know. I was about to head home. Would you like me to walk you to your place? These forces funnier. Punch all the birds? Damn it, I should have picked that one. Oh well. Let's make love. And then eat them. Mm-hmm. I was about to head home. Would you like me to walk you back to your place? Whoa. Yes or no? How's a bird gonna protect me as shit goes down? Yes, please. Alright. Mr. Nanaki demonstrates some extreme sleeping on the way home, but we arrived eventually. Extreme sleeping. Your house is very rustic, Dong. I like it this way. It's wonderful to have a place to come back to, isn't it? Wonderful indeed. He looks a little sad. Sir? See you tomorrow. Don't forget your homework. And so he left a somewhat hollow-sounding farewell echoing behind him. They can peck at your eyes. Or was it just my imagination? Today's an elective day. What should I do? Attend math class. I'm gonna go back to music class. Fuck all them other classes. I've been placed in charge of the timpani today. Last time it was the gong. Dong gong. What am I supposed to be? The musical gorilla? Yes. Mad leveled up charisma increased by 5. We got our finals back today. I'm not sure I did too well. Excuse me. Donkey Kong. I gotta write that down for later. Dong. Sir? Well done. You're getting even better. Keep up the good work. Oh, cool. Yes, sir. Success. I'm doing good at this fucking pigeon school. July 20th. Wait, what are we doing in school? What song is this? Let's go with this. Oh, yeah. I was going to say, yeah, because they're on the other side of the equator there. Today's the last day. It's been a semester already. Time to party. Sometimes it seemed long and sometimes it seemed short, but either way, it's summer now. I think Saki is said to help him clean the council room before going home. He always gets angry if I make him wait, so I should hurry. 1,000 times. Like those Donkey Kong bongos on the GameCube, but come packaged with a prescription for Viagra? KV, you're the best. Oh, they're above the equator? I'm fucking stupid. I have no idea about geography. You're late. I came as fast as I could. Sorry, Sakia. Let's start cleaning. Very well. First, move the shelf and chairs. There's dust underneath. Okay. Next, inside the cupboard, arrange the files by date. Okay. And then the floor, polish it at least 3 times, and the window... Hold on, are you telling me to do all that by myself? Who else is there? You, bonehead. What the fuck? Maybe I should stand up to him? No, you help too, asshole. Sakia, I'm the vice president, not the chairwoman. Is that so? My job is to help you, so maybe you should be taking the lead role in cleaning up. That's why I'm giving you orders. No, geez, that's not what I... Here, here's a mop, work. What? Tell that bird to shove it. Ray Gun, how's it going? Is not got to let you know. I wonder where you are. wonder what you do. Do you guys remember the video to this song? And like, there was a blind chick and she was like sculpting Lionel Richie's head in clay and it looked really fucking awkward. You probably have no idea what I'm talking about. That's okay. You know how to use it, right? Let's get started. You want to see the music video? Alright. We can maybe do that. Don't tell me you've never... Blind chick? Yeah, in the music video, he's like pining for this like blind chick. And like... She's a sculptor and stuff. And she like sculpts his head for some reason. It's like weird. Yes, the hair at the head was very accurate. It's very, like, you could, anybody who can sculpt Jerry curls is pretty amazing sculptor. This live stream is amazing. Talk about living in the lap of luxury. And so Sakia reluctantly helped me clean. Whoa, he did? I thought he might complain for a while, but he certainly can be obedient. I can play it for you right fast if you want me to. That way everybody can know what the fuck I'm talking about. Let me pause this for a minute. There we go. Get ready to be amazed. It's got to get saucy.
Listen up, everybody. Tony Billy Boy has been in prison for 25 years. He's only been out for 3 days.
God damn it, get to the fucking music. Man.
Maybe.
There is no more Brooklyn Paramount. It's been taken over by some college.
Or the Albie.
Here we go.
That's gone too. You're a regular Rip Van Winkle, huh? What have you been doing, you inside my
mind? What if you were in class and then all of a sudden some dude just starts singing? Like what?
A long time since I've been on a date. I sometimes see you pass outside my door.
Hello. Is it me you're looking for? In your eyes. See it in your smile. All I've ever wanted. Arms are open wide.
Cause you know just what to say. And you know just what to do. And I want to tell you so much. I love you.
Yeah, girl's blind. Okay, yeah.
It's okay.
Every breath you take.
I long to see the sunlight in your hand.
Hi, Laura.
And tell you time and time again
how much I care.
Sometimes I feel my heart will.
It is actually. If I can remember this video, then there's probably. Like Waluigi. Wonder where you are.
And I wonder what you do. Are you somewhere feeling lonely? Or is someone loving you? Tell me how to win your heart.
He's watching you along with Ceiling Cat.
But let me start by saying, too many memories, too many ghosts.
It's what I know. This and the can.
We could go to Florida, or we could go out west.
What are you telling me? When did this become?
Ha ha ha. No, sorry about that. Can you pause this? I guess not.
Hello?
You drew some quick Italian DBZ trash? Oh, good. You cannot pause, love, no. Are you gonna post that shit? Because I want to see it. You know what? If I ever have your number, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna call your house. I'm gonna be all like, hello, is it me you're looking for? And you're gonna be like, who the fuck is this? And I'll just breathe heavy and hang up. Let me stop by saying I groped you.
Mr. Reynolds, excuse me, but there's something going on in the sculpture class. I think you ought to check it out.
I've wanted you to see it so many times, but I finally think it's done. Tell me what you think of it.
Looks like fucking shit.
It's wonderful.
This is how I see you.
I made a giant version of your head. Which one? They're her. But if you had an enormous chin. There you go. Let me look at this here. Do this here. Oh, that's amazing. Fucking knife. Oh, yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Good work. Good job. Scroll down. That is fucking amazing. You can practically smell the meatballs. I can too. Anyway, back to this fucking movie or whatever we're doing. Good work on the knife too. That was amazing. I thought he might complain for a while, but he certainly can be obedient. Now then, the sooner we finish, the sooner we can get to go home and masturbate. It's easy to fall out of practice and get fat and lazy during summer vacation. And how? Let me go see some things. It's, let's see. A hunter-gatherer body is her way of life, so maybe I'll go running today. Time to fap. What are we doing? Wait. What? July 22nd. Ah, that was a good run. A true running girl's way to start vacation. I wonder how far I ran. I always lose track of where I'm going once the runner's high kicks in. Where am I? I must have wandered out of my usual stomping ground at some point. Which way did I come from? Don't fail me now, Paleolithic homing instinct. The sun's setting, I'd rather not sleep outside. Hey, you. Who this? A finch? Yeah, I have Facebook open, sorry about that. What do people want? A sparrow? That's not a sparrow, that's a finch. Her wing is resting on a motor scooter. Can we get with chicks too? As we lay, we can. This is looks a little bit vintage. How cute. I feel a strange pressure in my pants. I can tell right away that this sparrow isn't just any birdie. I'm from St. Pigeon Nations. I was out for a run and got lost. You ran all the way from there? You must be good. It's only about a 2-hour drive from here. What? I guess that's why my legs hurt. I wonder if I'll be able to run home again. Hmm? I like the cut of your jib. You just realized this live stream is the only free time I've had today. I've been streaming for almost 3 hours now. I'm sorry that this is, like, taking long, but now I'm, like, invested in this game. Anyone that determined deserves a ride home. Come on. The intimidating sparrow gestures at her scooter. It's a little small, but we should both fit, I think. Thank you. Koshiba Azami. I sell Tayoka. I'm not gonna try and tell me. Call me Azami. And thank you, Azami. Gotta get that pigeon booty. Mad, you're a very cautious driver. Carve it into your soul, kid. One accident is all it would take, and that would be the end of both our lives. It may seem strange to a young girl like you, but once you've lost someone, you'll understand. Oh shit. This is getting real right now. There's a far-off look in her eyes. I'm sure you know what you're talking about, but at this rate, I might just go get home faster by walking. Do you think we'll get there by dawn? Carve it into your soul. The speed limit for scooters is 50 kilometers per hour. They gon' fuck it? Yeah, how do you, like, fuck sooner? We gotta try and fuck sooner. We're not even going that fast. Following traffic laws is part of my credo. Isn't riding tandem against the law, too? That rule is for humans. Birds are light, so one or two more doesn't stop the brakes from working. We're fine like this. But I'm not a bird. And so we put it along at Zami's hyper-cautious speed. By the time we got to my house, it was almost light out. We gon' fuck? Still a long time until the semester starts, and I still have a lot of homework. Maybe you should apply for a part-time job since I have the chance? Yeah, we need to get a job. I think I saw a flyer at the station hiring high school students over the summer. It was the cafe, right? Work is for chumps? Yeah, it is. But maybe we can get a good job, meet some more birds to fuck. It's beautiful in here. Oh my. Aww. Pardon me, miss, but we're not open yet. If you could come back at no... Oh, sorry. I was here to ask about the job. Proprietor of the cafe is an extremely elegant parakeet. A true gentle bird, without a doubt. This must be what people mean when they refer to a mature attractiveness. All the students at school are young and hyper, and the most dignified birds are the teachers. Oh, is that right? Forgive me. I am called Rushara Kenzaburo. Fuck. I'm the owner of Torimi Cafe. I'm dong mad. I'm mad for dongs. Welcome, Miss Mad. I inspected a human. Are you going to interview me? I do not see any need to test such a wonderful young lady's desire to work here. I gotta hang out with birds, man. And I believe you will be much more capable than I at moving the boxes of coffee and tea about. I'll be glad to. After all, I am a 805 vitality girl. I don't know what that means. I shall be relying on you for this summer then, Miss Mad. It is perhaps a little sudden, but could you start tomorrow? Of course. I am glad. I shall be waiting for you here in my cage. Tomorrow then, Miss Mad. Are we gonna see his human version or what? Fuck. Today is my first day at working at Mr. Rushimar's cafe. I think I'll arrive early to make a good impression. When am I gonna get a house? Good morning, Miss Mad. Good morning, sir. Let me start by showing you where everything is. I'm sure you'll be able to remember everything soon, so please ask if you can't find something. He shows me around the cafe, explaining everything inside. The shop is small and he keeps everything very tidy, so I'll be able to remember it all. Well then, what do you think? It's very nice. I almost want to move in. Come now. It's far too plain for a young lady with such as yourself. Actually, compared to my house... They do fuck. I don't got 87 years. I want the D now. The B. Whatever. Excuse me. Oh, this guy. I saw the flyer at the station and... Ryota. Mad, what are you doing in here? A friend of yours, Miss Mad. Oh yes, this is Ryota. You came for the job too, Ryota? Yeah, I saw it that it starts at noon, so I thought I could fit it after my other job. But if you've already got the position, then that's that. Mr. Ushu, whatever. Could you use two people? Sadly, my cage is too small to have that much work to do. I should. I got the position, baby. He's got another job. I'm not giving him the fucking job. Oh, I'm sorry, Ryota, but I really want to do this. Don't worry about it, man. I've got a couple more places to check. A mystery man. Yeah, who the fuck are you, help? I need to know. Now I'm curious. Perhaps some other time I will be here if you are looking for something later on. I'll keep that in mind, sir. Some guy? Alright. How you doing? Are you on the Tumblr? Maybe yes, alright. Shoot me a message, Meng. We could get to know each other, know what I mean? Aw, oh, yeah. I'll keep that in mind, sir. Have fun, man. About opening time, I'm kind of nervous, but I'm not about to mess up after taking the job from Ryota. I wonder who the first customer of my life will be. Y'all get a new girl, a human? A budgerigar. Budgies would like this. Steps in the door, the first customer of my life, a young man who doesn't quite... sweet, think suit. The atmosphere of the cafe. I was hoping for some birdie who'd raise a few more flags. Maybe a white peacock? Peacock. Well, welcome. Would you like a bath or a meal? Or maybe like some you'd like Mr. Oosh or whatever? I'll take Kenzaburo. Hey, wait. Oh, shit. My body is telling me yes. Baby. I don't want to hurt nobody. But there is something to confess. You. Oh, fuck. Now whenever I hear R. Kelly, I'm gonna think about fucking birds. It should have played during the Wallowies You Are scene. Fuck. Oh well. Hey, wait just a minute now. Yes, a perfect delayed reaction. Oh, hello, Rabu. This is Rabu, Miss Matt, a regular customer. I'm something of an important figure here. See that card? 206 stamps? Amazing. Is he a cafe addict? Hey, what was with that when I came in? I wanted to provoke a reaction out of someone with a Kansai accent since I was a little girl. Flap, flap, flap. Thank you, Mr. Rabu. Thanks to you, my dream has come true, and I can die happy. Y'all lost me at the roadside there. Well, that's how it is. Mad, right? That seat there is my private property. Y'all remember that now. A new encounter in this little birdcage. Today is a good day. I shall make some coffee to celebrate. Please, sit down, both of you. Are we going to have an intervention? And so the three of us enjoyed an early afternoon pot of coffee. pot of coffee. That does sound like me. Wait, aren't I supposed to be working? Nah, work is for fucking suckers. I stayed out of town for too long and it's late. On my own, of course. Riding the stormy ways of life alone is what we humans are all about. Hey, human. Wow. This is amazing. What? Suddenly I'm surrounded by a bunch of unkempt pigeons. You go to St. Pigeonton's, don't you? Punk-gen. Right? My type. Don't you? I bet a rich little girl like you's got a lot of pocket money from daddy, huh? Rich little girl gonna get a fancy school, thinks she's so great. Gah. Darn it, I can't tell them apart. I can pick Ryota out of a crowd about 80% of the time, but rock doves are just... I meant just look all the same. Kind of racist. You have some business with me? If not, go away. Hey, that's not nice. Show us some cash first. Cash? They puff up their chest threateningly. Dumb punks. Picking on girls in the park is a good way to get ostracized for life. What? What? You little... They're angry now. My hunter-gatherer instincts can feel a fight coming. Three pigeons on my own. Can I win this? You bet. Slam. Thud. I kicked some birds' asses? Cool. The work of a moment. A dim figure flits out of the shadows, and an instant later, two of the doves are on the ground. Oh, I got saved? Cool. And the Rand Victor is... I don't know. A zombie? That was close, Matt. Are you sure you should be out this late? What the f- Who are you? Me? Well, I'm the takoyaki lady. Tacos. The dove collapses before the might of Azami's magnificent kick. Sorry, Azami, I let my guard down. Easy for a kid to do, life lesson. Always be prepared. Speak softly and drive a Sherman tank. She's so cool. I think I'm in love. Azami, I'm working at a cafe near here over the summer. In those jeans. I treat you something sometime as thanks. Is that part of your credo, kid? Goodbye, me. Azami takes the preferred flyer and mounts her trusty scooter and puts off into the darkness. A heroic entrance and a cool exit. Hope I can be like her when I grow up. Me too. Today is a local summer festival. I think I'll go with some birdie. Invite. Who should I invite? I'm going with Sakia. Over here. You've got nerve to call me out during vacation. What is it? Oh, right. You just moved here, so you wouldn't have known. Today's the festival. Let's go together. Festival? What's that? You'll understand when you see it. Come on. What in the... Shops, food, good fun all around. People can't possibly be eating food prepared like this. It's unsanitary. It's madness. Don't worry, there haven't been any reports of food poisoning for 2 years. So there were reports 3 years ago? Yep. And the panic-stricken Sakia around the festival was a little troublesome, but hilarious nonetheless. And so the night wears on. Huh? When did you get buy that candy apple, Sakia? It had an interesting color, so I thought I would buy one. I'm not going to eat it. I shall take it home and mount it in a case. Yeah, right. I'm gonna eat that shit. Time sure flies when I'm in here. See y'all around, Kenza bro. Oh, hey, Matt. Rabu finally heading home after staying in the cafe for much of the day, gestures to me out of his way out the door. Here, this is your tip. It's a magical candy from the pocket of an old lady from Osaka. Did the stream just disconnect? I don't think so. Magical candy from the pocket of an old lady from Osaka. So young men from Osaka can do it too. I don't know. See y'all around. Good day to you, Rabu. I think it's time to close up. Would you care for something, Med? It won't be as good as after sitting overnight. Is there any Tanjiro left? Of course. Here you are. Mmm. Tanjiro from a fancy cup is the best. Mmm. By the way, Mr. Urushihara? Yes. Mr. Rabu comes here every day, right? He does, yes. I wonder what he does. Is he a nice security guard or something? A chauffeur, apparently. He is generally out all night. He likes to come here to relax before work. Budjiguru or whatever. Who works at night? There are those among us parrots who prefer the night. The moon is wonderfully calming on a clear night. Rabu is renowned for being a very careful and reliable driver. And here I took him for the type to go wild behind the wheel. Haven't I met another careful driver recently? It's doing it again? Fuck. Sorry about that, you guys. I don't know what's going on. Lost internet connection? What? Attempting to reconnect. Lost internet connection? What the fuck? Hang on. It's back? No? Good? Whoa, what the fuck? Maybe it didn't like Careless Whisper? Maybe? Are we good? Everything okay? I'm scared now. I think Livestream is like, hey man, and Dick Game was too strong. I like Careless Whisper too. But I think we should, partying too hard, I think we should probably wrap it up here pretty soon. I've been streaming for 3 hours. And my ass is getting tired. So maybe what we could do, since this was a pretty interesting live stream, and I'm glad you all came out. I'm almost done dating my first burb. You can save this. So let me propose, god damn it. Local recording is complete. I don't know what that means. Well, anyway, so what I propose to you is this. We could kind of pause this and we could do another sexy romantic stream for lovers at some other time, like maybe in a couple weeks or a week or something. And we could kind of finish up this game. We could date somebody else in Wario date. Does that sound like a pretty good idea? God damn it. All right. Anti-lag figure triggered. Nah, let me try this. Fuck me. Are you serious right now? Hang on a second. I'm going. Things are happening. Can you hear me now? Or is it still bad? Fuck, it's still bad. I'm gonna save this. Oh fuck. What is happening? What is happening? No, stop. No, I need to go now. Fuck. All right. So, let me stop